If you want to initiate a strong web presence on the largest search engine in the world, I strongly suggest that you take advantage of Google and their free tools. Your brand new business needs a home base, a foundation from which all other branding activities take place, a root directory, if you will, for your business communications. Managing your Google Analytics, claiming your Google My Business page, or simply to create a YouTube channel requires a single email box to get started. The best way to start is to create a free Gmail account. Your Gmail address will become the root directory for your business activities. And if you have multiple email boxes set up with your company name, you'll be able to forward all of them to this single email box. Plus, respond to your emails as though it looks like it's coming from your company. You'll gain access to a plethora of other tools that are going to support your business. And you'll want to do all of this your first month of business. If you don't have it now, stop everything and get it done. Your business will thank you for it. I like to start all of my clients this way so they can control every aspect without being dependent on me, should I get hit by a bus. Of course, this is the Bootstrapper's Guide to Setting Up Your Gmail Address. Eventually, you can upgrade to the G Suite for small business for about $6 a month. But this initial setup gives you a taste of how it functions and the assets you can build and take advantage of inside this root directory. So, let's set up your Gmail address straight away. This should take you no more than about 2 minutes to complete. First, go to Google Account Creation page. There's a link in the description box below. Follow the steps on the screen to set up your account. My recommendation is to create a username meaningful to your business. Don't use your personal account. As I tell my clients, if ever you should have the option of selling your business, this asset contains the whole root structure and gets pushed to the buyer. It's never too late to create this root structure, but it will take work to separate your personal from your business property. As an example, I'll create a fake business name, Copernicus Cameras, and then see if I can grab a name close to that. Ultimately, I'd like copernicuscameras@gmail.com. Got it. Because I already have another Gmail account, I created Copernicus Cameras using the Add Another Account link button found at the bottom of my accumulated accounts. You can access this pane by clicking on the white initial letter found in the upper right corner of your screen. In this case, it's the letter N that represents Nick in the green circle. Now at this point, if you have a website set up with a host, chances are you'll get email boxes. If you're a solopreneur or have just a few people in your business, I recommend setting up at least 3 professional emails. For instance, your first name, hello, and support. So for Copernicus Cameras, I'll set up nick@copernicuscameras.com, hello@copernicuscameras.com, and support@copernicuscameras.com. You'll go into your cPanel and create your mailboxes and then forward them to your company email at gmail.com. If you can't do this, have your web designer do it for you. Under no circumstances do you share your company name at gmail.com. You want to hold this sacred, close to the vest, because you'll be using this email to perform your platform extensions like Google My Business, YouTube, Google Analytics, and so on. The other email boxes will attract spam as you publish them on your website and other platforms. This is just the way it is. When that happens, you can clean them out or delete them and rebuild them with a new password to sanitize the spam. Now, a couple of things you'll want to set up before you leave are to craft your signature with a new Gmail feature and download the Gmail app on your phone to access while you're out of the office. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Recently, as in May 2020, I noticed that Google added a pen icon to help you create a signature template for your future messages. Open a new message window and then click on the pen icon found on the bottom nav. The general tab found within settings will appear automatically with the signature position at the top, waiting to be created. Click Create New button and fill in the quick title of your first signature. You may want a few depending on how you answer your emails. In this case, I've created a general one. I've just typed in See Cameras and clicked the Create button to continue. Now, it will look odd, but what seems like a fractured window pops up to the right of your signature title box. go ahead and complete your full signature in this box. Like I said, I created a general one for Nick. It's simply Copernicus cameras, binoculars, and telescopes, and its byline, keeping an eye on the universe. Be sure to scroll to the bottom of the page to save your work. Always be saving. Now, feel free to experiment creating a new message. Click the pen at the bottom of the message and voila. It may come up automatically for you, or you can select it right there. Get the most recent signature tips in this video here when you're finished with this Gmail tech tip. Now, the next task is to hit up the App Store to download the Gmail app for your phone if you haven't already. Don't know if you've noticed, but as we are setting up the Copernicus camera account, there were a couple of quick links inside the setup, including Get Gmail for Mobile. You can grab the link via mobile number, scanning the QR code, taking the blue link, or heading straight to the App Store. Once downloaded, you can log into all of your Gmail accounts simultaneously and review your email. It is so helpful when you're out and about. If you're starting a new business or you've been established for a little while, grab your copy of the Small Business Brand Toolkit to get started. The free Small Business Brand Toolkit is a system that I start my clients out on that contains all the essentials for creating, launching, and growing a successful business. The tips that I provided here today with the Gmail account will be in there as well. Now, go out there and keep building.